Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا ما يهده الله فلا مضل له وما يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Verily, all the praise, and all of the magnification, and all of the glorification it is due to Rabbul Izzah Jalla Fi Allah. And I publicly, without any compulsion, or without any coercion, bear witness to La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The topic for today, bin ilai ta'ala, is everything Allah decrees is good for the believer. My dear brothers, my dear sisters in Islam, I've been having a tremendous amount of discussions with a lot of brothers online, through WhatsApp, through Facebook, through personal phone calls, through emails, through different types of dialogues in the highways and the byways as I'm traveling up and down the road, discussing, ya akhwan, about what's happening in the world and the uncertainty of what's happening. And they ask me, ya akhi, what's your position, brother, on this and on that, and on this and on that? What do you think, akhi? Are we at a state of crossroads right now where many of the people, they don't know which way to go, left, right? They have no idea, no clue what's going on. So I said to them, it's not what I think. It's what Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what they told us. What the prophecy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah's words and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's words aren't like the words of any man. No matter how eloquent a person could be in the Arabic language, in the Urdu language, in the Somali language, or even in the English language, no one is more eloquent than Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my dear brothers. So we find a very beautiful hadith, and this is narrated from Suhaib. He reported that the Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings be upon him, he went on to say, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ مُؤْمِنِي إِنَّ أَمَرَهُ كُلُّهُ خَيْرٌ وَلَيْسَ ذَاكَ لِأَهَدٍ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّهُ شَكَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرَ لَهُ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ دَرَّهُ سَبْرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرَ لَهُ وَكَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Hadith is collected in Imam Muslim, and this hadith is sahih, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that one of the greatest blessings of faith is the fact that everything Allah decrees for the believer, whether it is ease in hardship, will be good for him. And if he experiences ease, he remains grateful and rewarded for it. And he experiences hardship, he remains patient. So the Prophet went on to say, wondrous is the affair of the believer. Wondrous, astonishing. For there is good for him in every matter, that this is the case with anyone except a believer. Ya ikhwan. Then he asked Allah, is there any good for him? And if he is harmed, then he is patient and there is good for him. So ya ikhwan, for the believing Muslim man and for the believing Muslim woman, ya ikhwan, when you look at life, either you're in a state of praising Allah Azza wa Jalla for all the ni'am, all the great blessings that Allah gave you. Whether it's a pair of shoes, ya ikhwan, as I seen a Muslim brother the other day, he came to the masjid and he had holes in his shoes, ya ikhwan. Maybe some of us got 5 pairs of shoes, 10 pairs of shoes, 20 pairs of shoes, his brother had 1 pair of shoes. And we looked at the situation, ya ikhwan. He seemed to be content, having a state of qana'ah with what Allah had decreed him, ya ikhwan. And unfortunately, a brother pulled me to the side before I got a chance to go see that brother, because the brother had some other issues with his life and his problem with his youth. So when we look at the situation, the Muslim is between, again, we keep saying, Baina Manzilatayn. He is between being grateful to Allah, so he is shakiran, and also at the same time, ya ikhwan, he is patient, she is patient with the decree of Allah Azza wa Jal. So when you look at the believer, the one who truly believes in Allah, the one who believes in His Messenger, the one who believes in the Quran, as there's people now coming out bold enough, some of them even have PhDs, saying that the Book of Allah is not complete. I don't care about your PhD. The Book of Allah has been preserved from Rabbul Izzah, high above the heavens. So my dear brothers, my dear sisters in Islam, we have to understand that the believer, the mu'min, is better than the Muslim. And we're happy to be Muslim. Walillahi alhamd. It is a daraja, it is a level on the ascendancy to getting to amongst ya ikhwan, the higher levels of Islam and Iman and Ihsan. So when we look, ya ikhwan, I had the opportunity to read a book by Shaykh al-Islam. And that's hard to say that name. Shaykh al-Islam, meaning the Shaykh who understood more than Islam than he didn't understand Islam, and they call him Shaykh al-Islam, a Thani, some of them call him that. His name is Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullahu wa rahmatullahi wasi'ah. And in this particular book, ya ikhwan, he gave us just a few, showing us, ya ikhwan, that we need to be people that are trying to get to the next level, ya ikhwan. Being Muslim is good. Alhamdulillah, you're a Muslim. But at the same time, my dear brothers, the mu'min is different than the Muslim. The mu'min is different than the Muslim. Shaykh al-Islam, in his deep understanding, what they call istinba' or istikhraj, ya ikhwan, being able to go into the Quran and the Sunnah and to pull out things, concepts for us Muslims to understand. Because many of us, we just read the Quran for hasana and barakah, but not too many of us, we read it for tadabbur wa tadakkur, thinking about it, pondering over, understanding the ahkam, understanding the rulings, understanding the wisdom and the hikmah. Shaykh al-Islam, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he went on to say, and this is Surah Ali Imran, after I say, A'udhu billahi shaitan rajim, Bismillahi rahman rahim. This is one of the conditions of the people that are considered from amongst the believers. وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَا إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. You will be the uppermost if you are believers. You will be the cream of the crop. We find that, ikhwan, Allah Ta'ala, He goes on to say, وَلِلَّهِ إِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. But all the might, all the power, it belongs to Allah and His Messenger and the believers, not the Muslims, the believers, the mu'mineen. So we find that Ya'qwan al-Shaykh going on to say, so the servant is allotted supremacy, might, honor, in his accordance to his iman, his faith, in his establishment of the realities. So if he is lacking in any aspect of this, it is because he is lacking in aspects of his iman or her iman, either in ilm, knowledge, or action, amal, inwardly or outwardly. So Ya Ikhwan, when we look at the situation, the Shaykh is basically saying, Ya Ikhwan, that you want might and ascendancy and power and strength and quwwah, then you have to, Ya Ikhwan, you have to be a follower, a practitioner of Allah and His Messenger, if you're true believers. And we find, Ya Ikhwan, that when the Shaykh was writing his books, he made things easy, what they call taqreeb al-ma'na, making something easy, bringing it close for the people to understand. And he brought another ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Allah Ta'ala goes on to say, Allah will defend those who have iman. It doesn't say those who submitted to Islam, it said those who have iman. So the Shaykh goes on to say, so if the defense is lacking in any way, it is because of our own weakness in our own iman, that we have some deficiencies in our iman. Likewise, Allah suffices us in accordance to our faith, Ya Ikhwan. So if you have iman, if you really have iman, and who knows what real iman is, Ya Ikhwan, vast majority of us, we're barely practicing the five pillars of Islam. Many Muslims, they haven't paid zakat. Many Muslims, they haven't made hajj. These are the five pillars of Islam. We're still trying to do the basics, Ya Ikhwan. It is a lifelong goal just to do the basics for some people, to get up and pray five times a day. A lot of people, they're struggling with it. Hey, sometimes I struggle with it too, Ya Ikhwan. This is the reality of the hayat dunya. Call Allah Ta'ala, and this is a caveat right here for us to understand, brothers. We have the Quran, but are we reading it slowly and trying to understand and implement what's being said? Well, call Allah Ta'ala, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu, O Prophet, hasbukullah. Allah is sufficient enough for you. Wa min ittaba'ka minal mu'mineen, for you and for the believers who follow you. Ya Ikhwan, this is really important. Don't miss this point. O Prophet, Allah Ta'ala is talking directly to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Allah is sufficient enough for you and for, not the Muslims, the believers. The condition is following the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If we were to ask the brothers, if we were to ask the sisters, do you even have a copy of the seerah, the life of the Prophet ﷺ? Do you have any of the translations, any of the Arabic or Urdu or any language that you speak, a biography of the life of the Prophet ﷺ to show you his character and his manhood and his mission? Most Muslims, they don't have it. Oh, it's expensive, Akhi. It costs $30 for that. This is the messenger of Allah ﷺ. We want to know about Jeff Bezos. We want to know about Bill Gates. We want to know about Elon Musk. As we said before, the Muslims know everything about these guys. They've got billions of dollars. They went to space. He did this, he did that. He has this million and this trillion dollars. But the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have we inherited the maraf, the inheritance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in loving him, loving his seerah, loving his sunnah, loving his akhlaq, loving everything about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who was sent to guide all mankind to the righteousness, Ya Ikhwan. I come from a religion where our family, they put Isa and Maryam on such a high level that they started to worship Isa and Maryam. And I grew up for almost 20 years of my life understanding that until Allah, He guided me to Islam. And then we realized that all the prophets came with one message, to worship Allah and to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So for us brothers, I have cousins. They say to me all the time, Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. And I say to them, I just want to let you know, cuz, that there is no J in the Hebrew language. There's no J. So then they start to deflect. And I say, well, He still loves you. And I said, yes, I know that. But also Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He loves you too. And Allah loves you. But yeah, Quran, the question comes now for us, are we living, are we walking the talk, are we walking the walk, are we being practitioners of actually being like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Are our mannerisms like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Is our tonality and how we deal with the Prophet is like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Or are we trying to be like the people in the streets, ya Quran? I come from the streets. I know what that behavior is, ya Quran. I'm still fighting my own nafs, ya Ikhwan. In my culture, one of the cultures, I have many cultures, and I'm shy to say this, but at the same time, in our language, we have some really bad ways to say some bad things to some people. And because I'm always around my cousins that are non-Muslim, I hear them saying these bad words all the time. And it's something that I have to, intrinsically, I have to fight it, ya Ikhwan. Because sometimes someone, they may step on your toe, they may drive in front of you, someone may cut you off, someone may speak to you badly, and it's hard, ya Ikhwan, to bite your lip at that time and to not swear and to say something bad, because the Prophet ﷺ, he didn't do that, ya Ikhwan. It ain't something to say. So when we look at ourselves, ya Ikhwan, wa qala Allah Ta'ala, he goes on to say, Wallahu waliyul mu'mineen. That Allah, he is the friend and protector for the believers. It's mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah and Surah Al-Imran two times. Wallahu waliyul mu'mineen. Allah, he's the friend. Do we not need Allah as our friend, ya Ikhwan? We have people that we call up all the time for favors, and they call us to discuss their problems. But do we have Allah as a friend? Do I have Allah as my friend? Also, Allah Ta'ala goes on to say, wa anna Allah ma'al mu'mineen. Allah, he's with the believers. He's with the believers. Again, I emphasize, brothers, not the Muslims. The Sheikh, when he was reading the Quran, and this is just a few, there's even more, showing ya Ikhwan, the believers, the mu'mineen, they have a status that when they actually are on that level, may Allah make us from them. May Allah make us from them. Ameen. That Allah Ta'ala will help us in ways and places, ya Ikhwan, that we can't even fathom, ya Ikhwan. أقول لكم هذا استغفر الله لي وسلم المسلمين اجمعين فاستغفروه انه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين واصلي واسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى اله واصحابه اجمعين. Coming from the darkness to the light, my dear brothers. There's a word for it called phototaxis, or phototaxis. So we find, ya Ikhwan, the scientists have said that when the light is on, certain animals, certain entities, they flock towards the light, like the moth. But then when you shut off the light, you'll find, ya Ikhwan, that certain creatures come out, like rats, like cockroaches. Some go towards the light, some run away from the light. The light has been put in front of us, dear brothers. It's called the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But now when we look at the situation, ya Ikhwan, there is one hadith, and there's been many imams, they've explained this hadith in great detail, and some of them, they're better than me. But this is one of the first hadith that gave me hope when I first became a Muslim, showing, ya Ikhwan, that everything is in the hands of Allah Azza wa Jal, and that basically you just have to make your effort. عن أبي هريرة قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المؤمن القوي خير وأحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف وفي كل خير احرص على ما ينفعك واستعين بالله ولا تعجز وإن أصابك شيء فلا تقول لو أني فأت كان كذا وكذا ولكن قل قدر الله وما شفع أهل فإن لو تفتح أمر الشيطان أخرجه مسلم. This hadith has been authenticated by Imam Muslim rahmatullah alayhi. We went on to say that Abu Huraira reported that the Messenger went on to say that the strong Muslim, no, the strong believer, again, distinction, clarifying the issue, not the strong Muslim, the strong believer is more beloved to Allah than the weak believer. So ya Ikhwan, it could be physical strength, it could be your mind, it could be your Islam. Scholars have explained it in a different way. The man who's physically strong, not that many people can beat him up. The man who's weaker or is old, people can probably push him around. But the one who has Iman, strong Iman, no matter what comes his way, He's going to be able to deal with the fitness and the test of life more than the weak believer. So the Prophet went on to say, but there is goodness in both of them. Be eager for what benefits you. Strive for what's beneficial to you. And do not become frustrated. Many people now, especially the Muslims, have become very frustrated. And ya ikhwan, the epidemic of opioids and marijuana and cocaine and crystal meth and fentanyl, you'd be shocked to find the Muslim names that are at the top of the people in the jail, as well as the people consuming these things, because they're frustrated, ya ikhwan. So they turn to these things instead of Rabbul Izzah, Nasamahullah. So Allah, the Prophet wanted to say, if something befalls you, any fitna comes, then do not say, if only I had done something, if I would have went to the left, if I would have went to the right, if I should have zigged, if I should have zagged, if I should have zagged, if I should have zigged, but rather say, Allah has decreed what He wills. It's from the Qadr of Allah. From Iman is that we believe in the Qadr, ya ikhwan. This is what distinguishes us from other people. Even the non-Muslims, they have a word for it called providence. They even know about Qadr. But now if you try to explain this to them, many of them will say, well, I don't know, I have a lot of free will. Yes, you have the free will to go this way or that way, but whatever happens, it's all from the decree of Allah. And verily the phrase, if I would have did this, that would happen. If I would have did that, that would happen. The Prophet went on to say that if it only opens the way for the devil, for the shaitan. The devil, brothers, is constantly whispering to us. Sometimes he whispers to us on our cell phone as we're texting during the khutbah. He's whispering. Unless it's a 10 gazillion billion dollar trade that you're doing on your phone, which is still not worth you losing your Jummah, my dear brothers, for those brothers that are texting. The Jummah comes only once a week, brothers. Only once a week. If you hear some words that are the words of Allah and His Messenger, and you get one benefit, and you were quiet, and you implemented it, then it was worth your time coming for Jummah, brothers. But if you came up here to hear entertainment from the sheikhs, then you wasted your time. None of the imams, I'm pretty sure I can speak on behalf of all of them, we don't come here for entertainment. We don't come here to make the people smile or laugh or make the people, you know, do anything. We come here yet just to remind our brothers about what Allah and His Messenger said, and that's it. Masha'ah. There's no other reason for us to be up here, brothers. It's to remind myself first, these ayats and hadith that are here, before I say them to anybody else, it's supposed to hit my heart and make me act. These hujjaj aren't just for play and amusement. La'ab. La'ibu wa'lahu. Play and amusement. These are to help us to correct ourselves, my dear brothers. So let us be people, as you believe, as you heard these ayats, for those brothers that heard those ayats about the believers, we ask Allah to make me and to make you from amongst these true believers. Because, brothers, just being a Muslim is not helping us. The Muslim, he raises his head and he wonders why his dua is not being answered. As you can see, just a few of the ayats here, there's some conditions. There's some conditions. You want the defense of Allah, you want the help of Allah, you want Allah to be your friend, you want to be close to the Prophet ﷺ, you got to be a believer. And brothers, to be a believer, that means that Quran and that Sunnah, we have to get a taste of it every day in our heart and in our mind. May Allah make me from amongst the people that follow the Kitab and the Sunnah, and you and your family and your children, and make us all from amongst the true believers. We ask Allah to send salat and salam on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala Ibrahim fil alameen, ya Rabbal Jin. May Allah help all the Muslims all over the world that are suffering, whether it be in the lands of the West or in the lands of the East or in places we've never heard of before. May Allah help all the Muslims that are being oppressed, all the Muslims that are, ya Akhwan, going through things that we can't even understand, ya Akhwan, because we ourselves never went through it. May Allah help them with money. May Allah help them with our prayers. May Allah help them every type of way, especially if there's one brother here. This is the khutbah for everybody here. If there's one brother here, or if there's one sister here that is a true believer, we ask you, and Allah, He knows who you are, make dua that Allah make us all better. Aqeem as-salah wa rahmakallah. So.